Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in. Today's video topic is art blog. Quick before the video, you can have premium quality art prints and much more on my Society 6 shop. If you are interested, click the link below. So before talking about what causes art blog and how to cure it, first we have to understand what art blog is. Art block means a period of time when an artist cannot access their creativity and they cannot create a new piece of work. There are so many factors that causes art block. Motivation. Motivation is the key whether you can create good artwork or not. If you don't have enough motivation, it is nearly impossible to achieve certain desires. So, how can you motivate yourself? First thing is you have to believe in yourself and make yourself think that you can do this. Stay away from negative things and toxic people. Even your non-artist friends can be toxic sometimes. They are not your friend if they don't accept or appreciate what you are, and in this case you are an artist. If they don't support what you create, then there is no need to waste time on them. But if their company makes you feel happy, then there's no reason to stay away from them. I have to make clear that this is just my opinion or what I think. You don't have to take it as a stick on stone. Follow artists on social media who inspires you. They don't have to be from this era. You can get inspiration from some historical artists like Michelangelo, Vincent van Gogh, Leonardo, Matisse, Raja Ravi Verma or whoever you can get inspiration from. It doesn't even have to be a person to get inspired to create artwork. You can take inspiration from some music, movie, web series or from your favorite anime series. And that inspiration can lead you to a new idea for your next artwork. Sometimes we cannot create art because we are after a unique art style. Probably you don't have to be called as a copycat artist. So you want new art style to make yourself different from other artists that can help you to stand out as an artist. What I think, you don't have to run after finding your own art style. Just draw or paint what makes you happy or what represents you best. Art means self-expression, right? So if you're gonna constantly think about you want a new art style, probably you won't achieve it, or it can even increase the duration of the process. If you are confused over what to draw or paint, what you can do is try everything. Try digital, traditional, like oil, watercolor, pencil, pastel, everything. And then choose what makes you most happy and what you find interesting. If you cannot afford digital tablet or oil paints, as we all know that they can be really expensive, you can borrow them from your friend, or if you don't have any friend with a graphic tab or oil paints, you can try drawing on smartphone. There are some really good artists who make digital art from their mobile, so don't make any excuse that you don't have any resource. Even I started this channel from filming with my smartphone, even though I don't have much subscribers, but I enjoy making the videos, that's what matters to me. And for oil paints, you can purchase student grade colors. They are way more cheaper than artist ones. Art block also depends on your mood. So you're making a drawing and your strokes are all wrong. Your lines are going in other direction, or you cannot render or shade your art correctly. It can be frustrated sometimes. Take some time off of your art. You don't always have to draw. Keeping your mind healthy is necessary. Go out for a walk, listen to music, treat yourself with your favorite food, or you can talk to your favorite person or the person you love. As I told you before, these things make you inspired, and a change of mind is very important. After taking some time off, you can plan a routine. Always include some time for yourself in your timetable. I know it sounds a little weird, but if you are an artist, treat your painting or drawing as an actual work. It is actually a work, but if possible, make a separate corner where you can do your artwork. Create deadline for certain piece. You don't always have to follow the deadline, but this will keep you motivated. Next thing for you to do is, do not compare your artwork with other artists. No one is good or bad in art. It's all about pace of learning and how much time you take to understand things. In the end, experience is how much time you give to your learning. With each and every piece of artwork, you learn something, and it becomes part of your experience. So if you are afraid of doing something like trying a very complicated and difficult drawing, just try it. It will kill your fear of making difficult artworks. Though, you have to first work on your fundamentals before jumping into some difficult subjects. So why is the artist you follow on Instagram or your friend in your fine art college is better than you? It's because they give more time in their practice and take it more seriously. There is no reason to compare your artwork with them. And it doesn't mean that if someone younger than you make better artwork than you, so you're bad. Maybe you started making art late in your age. They say learning is easy when you are younger. If you really want to compare your artwork, compare your previous work with your new ones and see how much you have improved. So what do we have learned today? Motivate yourself. How to get new ideas. Take a break from your work. Make a routine. Do not run after a unique art style. Art is self-expression, not comparison. Not having better art supplies is nothing more, just an excuse. Hope you found this video informative. Give this video a like if you like it and thumbs down if you don't. Tell me if you want me to make a tutorial video in the comments, or you can ask everything art related. I will happily answer them. So don't forget to subscribe. This will help me grow my channel and motivate me to create new artwork and videos. Thank you so much for watching the video. Namaste.